station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Gary Jordan. This week, a cargo spacecraft is set to begin its secondary mission before dumping 5,500 pounds of trash. Northrop Grumman's Cygnus vehicle departed the station on Friday. Before its fiery demise in the atmosphere over the Pacific Ocean, Cygnus will alter its orbit a few times to deploy several types of satellites from different deployers. The Slingshot deployer will release some student and commercial satellites, while the NanoRacks deployer will release the KickSat-2, which will deploy 100 much smaller satellites called Femtosatellites, weighing less than 3.5 ounces each. Cygnus is scheduled to re-enter the Earth's atmosphere in late February to conclude its mission in space. Canadian Space Agency astronaut David Saint-Jacques took a spin at an experiment that looks at fluid behavior. The Fluidics experiment is designed to look at a few aspects on how liquid moves in microgravity. The hardware consists of some transparent spheres and a centrifuge, specially designed to look at wave turbulence and liquid sloshing. Understanding how these phenomena are different in a microgravity environment could lead to better fuel systems for satellites, and even aid in improving climate predictions and renewable energy on Earth. NASA and its commercial crew program providers Boeing and SpaceX set new target launch dates for their upcoming uncrewed test flights. We're now targeting March 2nd for the first launch of SpaceX's Crew Dragon on its uncrewed Demo 1 test flight. Boeing's uncrewed orbital flight test is being targeted for launch no earlier than April. You can find out more and keep up with all the progress over nasa.gov/commercial-crew. This week's question comes from Nicole at RJO Intermediate School. She asks, how do astronauts breathe in a spaceship? Great question, Nicole. NASA astronaut Anne McLean was asked the same thing this week by elementary school students in El Dorado Hills, California, during a live event with the space station. We'll let her take this one.
The engineers on the ground have done an amazing job of creating this space that feels a lot like Earth. So other than floating, our temperatures and our air is almost exactly like we have on Earth. And that's actually because in order to live, we need certain things in our air, like oxygen.
Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.